this is really painted in the round. If you turn it right, it'll go, you see a studio with a model, but it all connects. And then...
My name is Rita Paul. I grew up in Paris. Yeah, I was interested always in art and music. Loved opera, and I played the piano. I wanted to draw, but I didn't know whether I had it or not.
This is Christina.
My father, I remember, asked someone, some business acquaintance, whether I had any talent. And I don't think you could determine by what I was doing. I wasn't talented, I would say. Not at all. Yeah, I got a bachelor's from Hunter in art.
We're getting. Oh, here you can see it with the additional floor.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's right. They added on a floor there at the top.
And also, there's a little car.
Electric car.
These are from the Museum of the City of New York.
Yeah. I think there is so much lost history with the hotel.
It was always an interesting thing if you did a little research.
And you can see the stained glass.
I found pictures of the Earle from that period.
When it was a residential hotel, there must have been some whole suites.
Yes, you know, it did.
This is from when? Like when you first took over the hotel?
No, this is just different things in the neighborhood. Oh, this is inside. We have no idea where this was. This was the dining room. Oh, this is 1917 when it was built, the corner.
I've also found some very nice postcards.
Yeah, I have memories because it was a fun place always. I would come on a Friday evening and sit in the lobby and look at who was coming down the staircase. And people came with a monkey, and you name it. It was a scene. On gay parade day or something, the 6-foot gays would be dressed as women. And they were, you know, it was a show. It was a lively place. This neighborhood was wonderful. We had empty rooms. And I decided to live in the hotel. My bedroom was right next to the elevator, and it was quiet and dark. No, it was wonderful. I loved being in the apartment, actually. I had a studio up there and a piano. Well, the years that I was living alone, I could work till 3 o'clock in the morning. It was a very happy time. It was a dump, but it was a better dump. You know, you looked in, you saw a dark corridor. People couldn't find their rooms because there were no signs indicating, you know, where the rooms were. Well, first of all, I started playing around with numbers. That's the first time I tried anything like that. And then I started playing around with the colors of the doors. There's nobody to stop me. My brother didn't want to do anything as far as decorating was concerned. Decorating wasn't really what he was about. So that's when I decided to do it myself. It was always whatever would look well in that particular space is what interested me. So I would experiment the way the tiles were in the bathroom. You know, I saw more interesting ways of putting tiles up. I did the columns in the lobby. There's quite a number of tiles. There's 6 or 8 columns. and they're fired more than once. It was slow, it was in stages. One of the big things is when we put in the marble floor in the lobby, which is still there. And then we changed the canopy, the entryway. We had seen one in France that we liked. We traveled a lot in Europe, and whatever we'd seen in other hotels, I would try to see if it could work for us. From there, I decided if you can paint numbers, why not paint pictures? And then I found the stuff to paint the tiles with. It was very homemade. You know, it wasn't professional. I was painting the tiles and then actually the climbs. I thought it would go with an old building. It was always a question of what goes in an old building. You know, the climps that are in the back of the restaurant were all together on one wall. And then we split them up the way they are hanging out. And I just wanted to make it more interesting. I think I like the portrait of the actress, the movie actress in the restaurant, Jean Harlow, with the big rose. That's one of my favorites. I like the Vogue covers, you know, they're on every floor, I like those. No, if they look okay in the spot is really what interests me. And I still have my own opinions at 91.